This is what it looks like to recreate the Big Bang. When the Large Hadron Collider fired up for the first time, some people were scared that it might destroy the world. Instead, it helped to explain why everything in the universe has mass. But now, scientists want to build something far more powerful, a huge 91-kilometer ring beneath the Swiss-French countryside, over three times larger than what we have today. The future circular collider will have the power equivalent of 10 million lightning strikes and could help us discover some of the biggest mysteries in our universe. Or it could discover nothing at all. And with a price tag of $17 billion, that's a pretty big gamble. Hey, I'm your host Regis, and today we're taking a look at how far we're willing to go to uncover the secrets of our existence. For over a decade, the Large Hadron Collider has helped scientists explore the particles that make up our universe, but it's just one of over 30,000 particle accelerators in use around the world today. You might be surprised to learn that 97% of these aren't used for physics research at all. They're working in hospitals treating cancer, manufacturing computer chips, or sterilizing medical equipment. The Large Hadron Collider is the most powerful of these machines ever built, a 27-kilometer ring buried beneath the France-Switzerland border.
As a layman, I would now say, I think we have it.
Scientists used it to discover the Higgs boson in 2012, the particle that lays the foundation for everything that we see around us. But the Large Hadron Collider is set to shut down in 2041, which is why CERN is looking to build the future circular collider. This enormous circle would cover an area larger than Chicago, running deep beneath both the French and Swiss territories, and even passing under Lake Geneva. And like its predecessor, it'll work by speeding up tiny bits of matter and smashing them together at incredibly high velocities. This collision creates a burst of energy, which can transform into new particles that don't typically exist in everyday life. It's Einstein's famous E equals mc² equation in action, energy becoming matter. But why build something so massive? Well, when particles travel in a circle, they naturally lose energy as radiation every time they turn. Think of it kind of like driving a Formula One car. On tight corners, you burn more fuel and lose speed compared to gentle curves where you can keep that momentum going. Building a massive 91-kilometer ring means scientists can create much gentler curves, letting particles keep more energy as they zip around. But the real question is, why do we need it? Well, to put it simply, there's still so much that we don't understand about our universe. Take matter and antimatter, for example. Every particle of matter has a twin called antimatter, which looks the same, but has the opposite charge. And if they meet, they instantly destroy each other. The Big Bang should have created equal amounts of both, but for some reason, the universe we see is made almost entirely of matter. The antimatter has virtually disappeared, so where did it go? Well, we can't answer that yet. And then there's another mystery. Everything we see, all the stars, planets, and galaxies, makes up just 5% of what's actually out there. But astronomers have found that something invisible is holding galaxies together, preventing them from flying apart. It doesn't emit light or energy, so we can't see it directly. But we know that it exists because of its gravitational pull. Scientists call it dark matter, and it's everywhere, even moving through us every second, completely undetectable. The future circular collider could help us finally learn what this is made of and give us answers to some other really big questions about the rest of the universe. So let's take a look at how they're going to build it, because this is where things get pretty darn interesting. See, unlike most megaprojects that you can go see for yourself, almost all of this project would be hidden underground. The tunnel will sit about 180 to 400 meters below the surface, deep enough to avoid disturbing anything above while winding through the rock layers under the Alps. Engineers looked at about 100 different configurations before finding the perfect path. The location offers stable ground conditions, works well with CERN's existing facilities, and provides good access points from the surface. Even so, there are also some pretty big geological challenges here. The planned 91-kilometer tunnel would need to weave through complex underground rock formations and known fault lines. And it would need to stay perfectly aligned for decades. Even tiny shifts could mess up the sensitive equipment inside. With a project this big, the amount of material they'll need to dig out is hard to imagine here. Over 5 years, they'd need to remove about 16 million tons of rock and soil. To put that into context, the Great Pyramid of Giza only weighs 6 million tons, so you can almost build three of them with that much rock and dirt. And it's not just a tunnel, either. Four huge experimental halls would be positioned around it, and it's here where the massive detectors will capture particle collisions, the moments when new discoveries might actually be made. There will also be service caverns containing all the maintenance equipment and technical systems needed to keep everything running smoothly. What makes the project even more impressive is that it's actually designed for two different particle accelerators over its lifetime. First, the FCCEE would allow scientists to study around 1 million Higgs bosons in precise detail. Then, after that finishes its research program, they'd transform the same tunnel to house the FCCHH, which is the collider that could reach energy 7 times more powerful than the Large Hadron Collider. This second machine would start working in the 2070s and continue experiments for about 25 years. On the surface, the project would have a surprisingly small footprint with just 8 different surface sites, 7 in France and 1 in Switzerland. Would you ever consider traveling to a project like this, or maybe even doing a tour there? Well, before we dive into what the future holds for this project, a quick thanks to our sponsor, Sailie. Sailie is your ultimate travel companion for staying connected abroad. They offer affordable eSIM plans in over 190 countries and 8 regions. And here's the best part. Beyond single country plans, Sailie also offers regional and global plans. So if you're hopping across borders, say from Switzerland to France, you can stay connected the whole time with Sailie's eSIM for Europe. When you're traveling, you often arrive in a new country with no internet, and sometimes not even any cash. So the first thing I'd have to do is figure everything out. Where to go, how to get online, which ATMs to choose. Well, with Sailie, that stress is gone. You arrive and you're instantly connected. Simple as that. On top of that, it's super easy to set up. Just download the Sailie app on your phone. Choose a data plan for your destination. And lastly, get an exclusive 15% discount by using our code MegaBuilds at checkout. Give it a try and head to Sailie.com/MegaBuilds or directly download the Sailie app. Don't forget to use our code MegaBuilds. Thanks again to Sailie for making this video possible. And now, let's take a look at where the future circular collider is headed next. Actually, building the future circular collider is far from guaranteed. At the moment, geological checks are underway to see if the ground can support such a massive tunnel. And these will provide key information for the final feasibility study, which is due this year. After that, CERN's member countries will make a go or no-go decision around 2027 or 28. That's when the design work would finally begin, with construction possibly starting after 2035. So yeah, not exactly a quick build. If it does get the green light, the Future Circular Collider will be one of the most ambitious scientific instruments ever created. But that could be a pretty big if. The $17 billion price tag alone has caused plenty of debate. Is it really worth spending that much on a glorified science experiment? While part of the cost would be covered by CERN's existing budget, the rest depends on support from European countries and international partners. And that's just the start. Unlike a commercial product or a space mission, scientists working on the FCC can't promise any specific discoveries, or even that they'll find anything at all. When the Large Hadron Collider was proposed, no one could guarantee that it would uncover the Higgs boson. That same uncertainty makes this next machine a pretty tough sell, especially when there are so many other important things that need funding around the world today. And the real cost could end up far higher than expected. After all, we've seen this happen before. In the early 1990s, the US started building the superconducting supercollider in Texas, named Desertron. It began with a $4.4 billion budget, but ballooned it to over $12 billion before Congress pulled the plug, leaving behind an unfinished tunnel. Energy use is another big sticking point. Even with improvements over the Large Hadron Collider, the FCC would still draw between 1.1 and 1.8 terawatt hours per year. That's roughly enough to power every single household in Iceland. Not everyone in the physics world is thrilled about the project either. As former UK Chief Scientific Advisor David King put it, spending billions on it could be seen as reckless at a time when the world is facing urgent climate threats. And Donatella Lucchesi, a particle physicist at the University of Padua in Italy, thinks that CERN's focus on the future circular collider is a mistake. She argues for alternative technologies like muon colliders, which could fit in a ring 10 kilometers around. That's just over a third of the size of the current Large Hadron Collider and a tiny fraction of the FCC's 91-kilometer circumference. And despite its smaller size, a muon collider could still probe the same high-energy physics, thanks to the unique properties of muons. They put all their energy into collisions, while protons waste most of theirs. The catch? Well, muons are much more unstable, decaying in microseconds. On the other hand, supporters argue that, yeah, $17 billion seems enormous, but when spread across so many years and all those different countries, the yearly investment is a bit more reasonable. And on the plus side, the first phase of the future circular collider could generate over $4 billion in local economic benefits through jobs, contracts, and spin-off technologies. Ultimately, though, it comes down to this. Throughout history, basic scientific research has led to unexpected benefits. Take the World Wide Web, for example. Here's a fun fact for you. It was actually invented at CERN in 1989, and the very first web page in history was on CERN's server. Nobody back then could have predicted how dramatically it would change our society. And that's the key argument. Yeah, it's expensive, but what if we actually discover something truly groundbreaking? So, with all that in mind, what does the future hold for the future circular collider? Well, the debate is just getting started. Right now, everyone's waiting for that big feasibility report that is wrapping up soon. It'll determine whether or not this can actually be built. As you watch this right now, engineers are drilling deep into the earth beneath France and Switzerland, pulling up core samples and mapping the underground landscape. All this research builds toward a historic decision in the next couple of years. Do CERN's member countries invest billions today for scientific discoveries that won't fully materialize until the 1970s, if they materialize at all? Most scientists working on the project now will be long retired before seeing the final results of their work. Think about that for a minute. All the people designing the future circular collider are creating something for researchers who haven't even been born yet. They're betting that our drive to understand the universe will continue for decades to come, no matter what the future might bring. But what do you think about the future circular collider? Will it ever become reality, or will the challenges just be a bar too high? Let us know your thoughts in the comments down below. If you want to see more ambitious megaprojects, you should watch our video about China's $100 billion Himalayan megadam, where we explore another project that pushes the boundaries of human engineering. As always, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you in the next video.